In Nova Scotia, people who are not considered a high risk and have COVID-19 symptoms are no longer required to take a PCR test. Rather, they'll have to use a rapid test kit at home and self-manage. But that is raising a number of concerns. Tanaeya Young joins me now. She's a COVID long hauler joining me from Halifax in Nova Scotia. Thanks for coming back onto the program. It's been some time since we talked.
Yeah, no problem, Angie.
How are you doing?
I'm doing a little bit better than when we last talked, but not fantastic still.
Talk to me about what your concerns are. We've been hearing new guidance coming in really right across the country, but Nova Scotia announcing how it was going to focus its testing on. You're concerned about that in terms of what it means for someone such as yourself, but others as well that are either ill from COVID-19, could potentially become long haulers. Because there's a concern what one needs to do in order to stay safe, but also to be informed.
Yeah, so I'm someone who's been struggling with the long-term COVID symptoms for almost 2 years now. And one of the biggest issues that I've personally had is that I never had a positive lab-confirmed COVID test. And the new system that we're seeing in Halifax is telling people, essentially, if you think you have COVID, but you're in between, 20 and 50, just assume you have it, maybe take a rapid test, which they're notoriously not that accurate. Assume you have it and isolate. The issue is that I've been assuming that I had COVID for 2 years now, and it stopped me from getting a lot of medical attention that I would have otherwise gotten if I had a confirmed lab test. Mm-hmm. It's going to be happening to a lot of other people as the months pass, because people who are affected mainly by long COVID are young people under 50 who do not have pre-existing conditions. And those are the people who are not able to get a PCR lab test in Nova Scotia.
What do you want to change then, Tanaeya? What needs to change here? Because, I mean, we've had a lot of conversations with individuals such as yourself. We spoke to another individual, Susie Golden, an hour or so ago, and she was expressing her concern, and she's over in Ontario. What needs to change here? Does there need to be perhaps more of a federal focus or guidance on this?
I definitely think that the federal government does need to at least acknowledge the effects that long COVID is having on young people. I think the government needs to do one of two things. They can ensure that people who are taking these at-home rapid tests and they're young and they're assuming they have COVID, they get essential health care down the road. They get health insurance, like disability claims, they get those approved for sure. Mm-hmm. And they don't get treated differently because they're assuming they had COVID. That needs to be the exact same as getting a lab test. Mm-hmm. Or they need to be doing more to making sure these people are still getting their tests confirmed.
Yeah, we're going to continue to follow it, Tanaeya. Have more conversations with you and others in the new year. In the meantime, I wish you well. I wish you good health into 2022 indeed. Tanaeya Young is a COVID long hauler, really speaking about a lot of concerns here. Thank you so much for giving me your time. Stay safe.